Mr. Excel podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel, episode 1438, Variable Rate Loan Payment. Well, hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. I'm back from my trip to Milwaukee. I did three seminars for the IIA yesterday. Some great questions came in. I was showing how to do loan payments like I normally do, the PMT function, and Heidi, who was in the audience, asked the question, well, how do you calculate a variable loan payment? And it's funny, they don't have a function for variable rate loan payments. So this is the best that I can come up with. We have our amount borrowed, that's the original one. All right, so amount borrowed, $120,000 over 180 months. And the interest rate starts out this great introductory 2.5%. But then after 5 years goes to 6%, after 10 years goes to 7%. So that's kind of my table there. I built a table at the bottom that shows the months from 1 to 180. And I'm just going to put in a guess of a payment of 917 for right now. We're going to come up with the real payment. So the payment each month is that 917. I'll press F4. The rate is going to be equal VLOOKUP. This is one of those weird VLOOKUPs where we're not getting an exact match. We are getting a range. F4, comma, 2. False at the end? No. Don't even have to put true. Just leave it blank. And that's going to... Need to put which column? There we go. 2.5%. Let's format that as a percent. Good. So that means the interest this month is the prior balance. We're going to start with the prior balance here. Prior balance equal to prior balance times an interest rate divided by 12. And that means the principal is the payment minus the interest rate. And so our balance is the prior balance minus the principal portion of the payment. So that interest rate that's going to change each month. The principal will change each month. All right, so we have that. Let's double click to shoot that whole thing down. And we now have a table. I'm going to hit end down arrow and we'll take a look. All right, so right now that payment that I have is not correct. It is, frankly, too high. And so we're paying too much to the bank. Now, to figure out the exact payment, we're going to go to Data, What If Analysis, Goal Seek, and let's bring this up here. I want to set that final value, that closing balance, to $0 by changing the temporary payment number that I put in at the top. So we'll cruise back up there. That is in cell C14. Click OK. Click OK. So there we go. Our answer of 888.59 will get us the amount. Now, the hassle with this is if you would change something. So let's say we decide that we're going to borrow $125,000. Well, that doesn't recalculate. That doesn't recalculate. What you're going to have to do is go back, try the whole thing again, choose that last cell, what if analysis, goal seek, set that to zero by changing that. Click OK. All right, so a little bit of training there. That you're going to have to go through that set of steps every time that you change anything. Maybe we could even macroize that or something. But I think this is probably the best way. Now, what's going to be interesting is I've never had to deal with variable interest rate loans, and I'm sure a lot of people have to do this all the time. If you have a better way to do this, shoot me a note, bill@MrExcel.com. We'll put it on a future podcast, get you one of those Excel master pins. So that's my way for right now. Let me know if there's something better. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. I want to thank Heidi for that great question at the IIA seminar. See you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.